Hey guys, I'm Mercedes and welcome back to this week's industry news. Our first news segment of the night comes from Germany. Babylon Berlin is the new hit crime drama series that aired last week in Germany. The new show set a record for the network, Sky, bringing in an audience of 1.19 million people. The network itself has around 5 million subscribers. Babylon Berlin will premiere on Sky UK later this year and on Netflix in early 2018. Ireland is making news with the film industry's special effects. Dublin's screen scene has been in the works on the effects for Game of Thrones. The nation's thriving effects houses have been banding together to service larger projects as well. Ireland's new tax incentive program also allows projects to apply for a tax break at any time during the production process, rather than just at the beginning. This contributes to the growth of the attraction as well. More industry news is coming out of Ireland within the animation industry. Not only are special effects houses on the rise, but animation companies are booming as well. Some of the bigger animation projects, The Secret of Kells and Song of the Sea, have received Oscar nominations in past years, along with the company Brown Bag Films, which produces kids' shows for Disney and Nickelodeon. Right now, there are more than 2,500 people employed in animation directly in Ireland. This week, it was announced that British actor and comedian Eddie Izzard will star in the new Australian comedy, The Callback. Izzard will be playing the character of Henry, who is romantically entangled with restaurateur Ronnie, who is played by Emily Tawney. Other actors cast in the film include Vanessa Guide, Luke McKenzie, and Hugh Sheridan. An update this week on the Harvey Weinstein case. Throughout the last week, the online campaign #MeToo was trending on Facebook and Twitter, which involved individuals coming forward and telling their personal stories of sexual assault in regards to the actresses coming forward in the Weinstein case, and mentions of other men in power as well. In regards to Weinstein himself, he may be facing prosecution in Utah. Rose McGowan reported that Weinstein raped her at the 1997 Sundance Film Festival. Although the statute of limitations has passed since, there's a possibility that he may be able to be prosecuted since he is out of state. However, some constitutional challenges may come about. As of now, no indication that a move by authorities is imminent. Unfortunately, guys, that's the end of our show tonight. But if you want to see more, don't forget to follow us on Facebook and on Twitter at @ENB_IUPTV. Make sure to tune in next week for more of your favorite news. See you next week.